What's going on, guys? Victor here, and today is a video I've been wanting to film for a long time. Now, you guys know I'm all about the exotic species when it comes to the catch clean cooks. I've eaten ballyhoo before, anchovies, pretty sure some other type of bait fish, but today we're going after probably the tastiest bait fish and gonna eat them, and that is the...
We're catching live sardines, boys. Just came in off offshore, and we're marking them. We're gonna catch them good. I'm excited. I don't know. I might keep one. I don't know.
Oh, okay.
I'm a little suspect on Victor, but you know me.
Adam doesn't think they're gonna be good. I know they're gonna be good.
I don't know what I did here.
So what we're after today is, if you've ever seen canned sardines, well, pretty much the same thing. I'm not sure if they're the exact same species, but they're a sardine species, and they're gonna be really good. So we got our sabiki rigs, which we use. They have these little quills on them. They're like little flies, and they have colors. Sometimes they're red, sometimes they're green. And we're out at a spot that holds some bait in the springtime. So let's see if we could get a few stringers of sardines. So you're gonna see us using this thing all day long. This is a de-hooker, because they're gonna pen them up and keep them as live bait, and you do not ever want to touch bait that you're gonna pen up or use as live bait, because it takes the scales off, it damages them. So we use this little guy to take them off the hook, and it makes it really easy too.
Straight south.
So now we kind of just drive around, and sardines will do one of two things. You'll either mark them on your depth finder, or they'll be skipping up top. You'll usually see kind of like ripples up top. Usually more so in the morning, but sometimes during the middle of the day too.
You went through a cloud of them, Victor.
Uh-huh. So what I like to do is, you never want to reel all the way up. You want a full stringer, so you kind of leave them down there. One gets on, it kind of traps the others. One person usually de-hooks, and one person holds the rod. It's the easiest way. Oh yeah, hit him. And these baits are strong. They'll literally pull drag when you get a full stringer of them. CJ will do is, we try to mark them on the depth finder, you'll see a big ball of them, so we kind of just drive around and just drift over them, and every drift you catch a few. Sometimes there's acres of them out here, but if there's not a lot and they're just in a big ball, you got to drive around constantly to get on top of them. All I'm doing is kind of jigging that sabiki rod, and that little fly that I showed you guys on that hook is just kind of fluttering in the current. And they think it's plankton or a little tiny minnow or something, or a little shrimp. Oh yeah, we're in the meat. It's the greatest feeling in the world. Look at this! Woo, baby! I hope you guys are as excited as I am to eat a Spanish sardine. I personally love canned sardines. That's something my family grew up on. Like when we made tuna salad, we always took a can of sardines and mixed it in with the tuna salad, because they have a really rich, deep, oily flavor, and I absolutely love them. So, to fillet, well not to fillet, but to clean a Spanish sardine, I've never done it, but I know that they have a ton of scales, so I just got a little kitchen knife. We are gonna knock off all the scales of this sardine, including the belly, sides, around the dorsal area. You want to go from the tail to the head, because scales run from the head to the tail, so you want to go against the grain of the scales. Now we're going to give it a little rinse. This is the only fish in the world you can probably clean with a butter knife. Now, I'm just going to take the head off. Just a matter of that. Take the head off. I'm going to take my thumb, or whatever, my finger, and I'm going to go all the way down and remove all of these guts. So the head's out, guts are out. Now if you look in there, here's the fish's backbone. I'm gonna take my pointer finger get underneath that backbone and delicately just pull it out, and you're going to see all these little bones on the side. They're going to pull out right with it. But you want to do it pretty gently because you don't want to mess up the meat too much. Okay, so we've removed the backbone. So now you got like a little butterflied sardine. And I've never done this before, so if you guys have a better way, comment below. But I think that this is probably the best way to do it, is to kind of just feel around and try to remove any bone you feel. And they also have these pesky little bones right here on the belly. You have these pesky little bones here around the belly. You know, when you eat canned sardines, you eat all the bones, and they don't bother me. But then again, when you eat canned sardines, they're preserved in olive oil or water. I don't know if it's the process of canning them for a really long time that makes them very fragile and kind of makes them disintegrate. But these, I don't think, would be very good to eat from a fresh sardine. I've never seen anyone eat them, but I could be wrong. So if you guys have ever had it, go ahead and comment below. And so when I get into the kitchen, I'm going to give this one more rinse. But you know, for a bait fish, this has a lot of meat. And I know it's going to have a really good flavor. That was a Spanish sardine. Now this right here, this is a cigar minnow. I'm going to do the same thing with my butter knife and remove any scales or any of the slime off of this fish's skin. These cigar minnows do not have they don't have the same type of real thick scales, but they do have quite a bit of slime. So we're going to just knock that off. And these little bait fish, they're very fragile, so you don't want to be too aggressive. That's why I'm using this little butter knife. Remove the head. Once again, I'm going to take my finger, go along the gut cavity, remove any of these guts. And I'm not sure if we're going to be able to do the same thing we did with the sardine, because I think this is a lot more. Well, it looks like we can remove some of those bones. I'm also going to remove this dorsal fin right here, where all these little fins you can kind of just pick apart with your fingers. So for now, I might do a little bit more research when I get into the kitchen, but this is the way I'm going to leave it for now. So I'll see you guys there. I am beyond excited to try these. So let's see what we can whip up. So we are going to try our sardines and cigar minnows two ways. Like halfway through cleaning the sardines up, the majority of them I kind of butterflied and tried to take out the dorsal fin and all those bones. But then I thought I remembered seeing a YouTube video where people just gutted them, took off the head, then you pan fry them, and once the meat is cooked, you should be able to lift the backbone out, which is the second method we're gonna try. So, but before we move on, I'm very excited to announce that the second channel that I've been talking to you guys about, I did start a second channel, it's just called Victor Hlubin for now. I'm gonna have it linked below, and I would love for you guys to come along on the journey, the adventure, and I have no idea where it's gonna take us, but it's gonna be exciting. So go ahead and check that out in the description box below. Why am I wearing a black glove? Well, the other day I was flying fish. I had an accident, accidents happen. I ended up getting 4 stitches on the tip of my finger. So if you guys see me wearing a black glove on my left hand for the next few videos, that is why. And it's also kind of like limiting my range of motion. I can't move this finger that much. So lesson learned, be very careful when handling knives. Accidents are bound to happen. So seriously, be very careful when handling knives. Very simply gonna season them. Sardines have so much flavor that they do not need much. So we're just gonna do salt and pepper on both sides, as well as, of course, a little bit of garlic powder, because you know, Vic loves him some garlic powder. Brick and I probably go through this much garlic powder once a week. No joke.
No.
It could, okay, once every 2 weeks at least. We go through a lot of garlic powder. I'm really excited to try these because I want to know how they're going to be compared to canned sardines. I'm not sure if it's the same species, but it's got to be similar. I couldn't imagine that all the different sardine species taste very different. I know they're really oily, which is good. I like oilier fish, you know? A lot of people avoid oilier fish because they think it's too fishy, but hey man, you're eating fish. That's what you're supposed to be tasting, is fish. We just have a nonstick pan, olive oil, medium heat, and let's just fry these babies up. Can't imagine them taking very long. So the ones that are butterflied, I'm not gonna flip because I want that skin to get as crispy as possible. But the ones that I left whole, I am gonna flip. Our sardines are done. And the flat pieces or the butterflied pieces, the skin got really crispy. The cigar minnows, skin didn't get too crispy. Which is what I love. See, look at these guys. That's the flat, the butterflied sardine, and the skin is super crispy, which I think is delicious and highly underutilized when cooking fish. A lot of people discard the skin. I think that's where a lot of the flavor is. First, I'm gonna do the butterflied, which is right there, and hopefully there are no bones. Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah. Wow. Okay. So first impressions, not as oily as I thought it was gonna be. I like really oily fish. Very mild, but rich flavor. Super flaky, I mean, about as flaky as you can get. Baitfish have very small flakes between every strand, like between the muscle fibers. That skin crisped up beautifully. This is the cigar minnow that I'm eating right now. So good. So that was the cigar minnow. Now here is the sardine. Take a look at that. And I do see some bones. That's what's kind of freaking me out. Between the cigar minnow and the sardine much oilier, much more rich, deep seafood flavor. And there's a piece of the bloodline right there. That's that really dark meat. And I don't know if I should be, I don't know if I'm being a baby with the bones. I'm just gonna go for it. The bones are so small and fine. And I'm not telling you guys to go out and try fish with bones, by all means. Be very careful, that is not what I'm saying. But these sardines, they're tiny. It almost looks like little hairs. So I had the cigar minnow, the sardine butterfly. Now this is the sardine that I left whole. Let's see if I can pull backbone like I said I was going to. So it should. It's very hot. Very, very hot. Well, that just kind of fell right off the bone. Oh yeah, baby. This brings me back. I ate a lot of canned sardines growing up. My grandma loved canned sardines, canned anchovies. It's really big in Slovakia to eat canned tuna. We made tuna a lot growing up. And we always mixed it with canned sardines, which I told you guys, it's a much more strong flavor. It's so good.
Let's see if we can see those bones.
So look at this. This is the backbone. This is what I thought was gonna happen. It kind of just pulls right off. So you're left with all meat. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at that. That's what I'm talking about. If I were to do this again, I would leave them all whole like I did, and then you can just pull the backbone out like that. Isn't that cool? Tell me that is not freaking cool. Go ahead and like this video if you guys think that is cool right there. You got yourself a little boneless sardine fillet, and honestly, they have a lot of meat for their size.
Looks like there's still bones in there.
There are, but they're tiny. Like, I would be terrified to eat a real bone because you don't want it to get lodged in your throat, obviously, but it is just so good. So this is the cigar minnow, and let's see if we can just kind of take the bones right out of the equation. There you have your fillet. The cigar minnows look like they have a lot bigger, thicker bone structure than the sardines did. The sardines have a lot more hair-like bones. That's the cigar minnow. You can see they're a lot thicker. I think it comes off much more. And the sardine had a lot more bone. It's a lot bonier. Wherever you guys are in the world, if you guys eat sardines, if you guys eat cigar minnows, comment below some of your favorite recipes. If you guys eat them, I know in Italy and in the Mediterranean, grilled sardines, big Spanish sardines, are very, very popular.
Look, this piece I'm eating looks like it's almost straight bloodline, if it'll focus. And there's those little bones in it still, which you can't taste at all. Oh, and my nail is green from dying Easter eggs. That's gross.
I will tell you one thing. This is not going to be the first or the last time I'm doing a Spanish sardine or a cigar minnow catch clean cook. Goggle eye is next on the list. There's a lot of baitfish to discover. This is honestly a ton of fish for six little sardines. If you guys ever get skunked, go ahead and harvest some.
It's like there's no bone.
No.
You don't taste the bone.
It doesn't make sense. One thing you could do, this is definitely a fish that does not need to be overly dressed or done up. You just take a little bit of lemon juice, that salt, pepper, garlic powder, olive oil, perfect little balance. Lemon juice for such an oily fish perfectly balances it out. I wanna thank you guys so much for watching this video. And like I said earlier, I did start that second channel, so go ahead and please, please check it out in the description box below. There's gonna be a lot of stuff like this, very heavy on the recipes and just all around food. Everybody's gotta eat, everybody likes food. So if you guys enjoy food, go ahead and subscribe to it. Once again, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in that next video.